So let's give this a taste. Yes, sir. Happy birthday to me. Awesome recipe. Hope you give it a try. Hello everybody, today we're going to make some baked potato. It's February 9th, today is my birthday. I am 40 something years old, young, what will it be? I am 40 something years old, younger. So before we begin this baked potato, let's sing happy birthday to me. Okay, are you ready? Let's go. You're going to fill in the spaces where I stop. Alright, let's go. 3, 4. Happy birthday to, happy birthday to, happy birthday dear, happy birthday to, yay! Oh, listen, you couldn't get more pathetic than this for a birthday, right? But I give God thanks for good health and strength. I am thankful that I have this big potato that I can put with this simple seasoning and put it in the oven. I am thankful for the oven. I'm thankful for the gas to cook the potato. I'm thankful for the light to get the oven going. I am thankful that I have good health and strength, and I live to see another wonderful year. I pray that this year and many more years to come will only be better than last year and all the other 40 something years that I have been on this planet Earth. I give God all the glory, honor, and praise. And I thank all of you in my YouTube community who are always supporting me for your love and your daily support on my YouTube channel. Now let us continue with today's recipe of some baked potato. Alright. So this is my birthday lunch. So I'm going to wash this baked potato. I'm going to wash this potato thoroughly. And I'm just going to give it a simple seasoning. Firstly, this is what I was thinking to do, right? To wash the potato, make a sauce with this, all the seasoning that I have here, inject the potato, and bake it like that. So I think I'm going to do the biggest one like that, and the rest I'm going to do what I'm going to do. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to inject one with the seasoning, and the others we're going to cut up in cubes and rub the dry seasoning on it and bake it. Let's see how the inject potato would taste to these potatoes that I'm going to cut into cubes and put the dry seasoning. I think if we inject this potato, it will be much more flavorful because, I mean, it is getting into the potato itself, whereby we're just rubbing the dry ingredients on the surface of the pieces of potato. But who knows, it might even taste as good, which I don't think so. Obviously, if you inject something, it will obviously get more infused with the seasoning than, you know, just rubbing it on the surface. But hey, when it's baking, it absorbs all the seasoning, so it could be really, really good. So I will be back after I wash the potatoes. We're gonna cut them up and inject them, and I'm gonna put all the seasoning in a bowl just to save time. All right, so let's go. Alright, so everybody is washed. So let's start with the potato that we're going to inject, alright? So what I'm injecting it with is this here, this concoction. This concoction has my homemade green seasoning. It also has some of my mint extract. So this has some white oak and mint. So this is what I used to make this. So I put some of this in there so it have a nice alcohol taste. You can omit that, okay? Then I add some smoked paprika and some celery powder. And that was all the seasoning. The green seasoning have salt, so I don't want to add any extra salt because, you know. Alright, so I'm just gonna, and I didn't want to add anything like black pepper. If you have the powder black pepper, you can add it. I didn't want to add no thyme or anything that is too chunky, because you all see how small the needle is, and I don't want anything sticking and not being able to pass through to get into the. Alright, so now after fully injecting our potato, we will let that soak in there while we cut up this potato, and we're going to rub this ingredients that we just mentioned in here. I don't want them too thick because I don't like thick potatoes. Okay. So I'm going to put them straight into the pan. I don't like thick potatoes. So we're going to cut them up. Not too thick. This way will be easier to get nicer pieces. So we're probably wondering, so why am I not doing anything for my birthday? Daughter so far away, working hard, ain't able to really do anything. So just chilling today, doing nothing much but baking a potato, enjoying our baked potato, and enjoying your content on YouTube. So these are the two. I'm going to do it off camera and we'll be back when I'm about to mix it up. Make sure every area of the potato is totally well coated. Then I'm placing in the baking dish. All this time my oven is preheating, and then I am placing them properly into the pan. And I more want the skin side not to be down on the pan, but the potato itself to be on the pan so it will cook properly. All right, so you all remember this curry blend infused oil. So I'm going to use a spoon. And take up some of these seeds and just sprinkle it on to the right. I'm just sprinkling these seeds. That's what I'm doing. Just taking out some of these seeds. Nothing else. And then these are the seeds I was speaking of. Just sprinkling some of them around it. So as it roasts, that curry flavor will come on it. And then once I do that, now I'm going to take up some oil and just drizzle on the potato. Not too much. Okay. I think I'm just going to give it another mix just to make sure, you know. We just give it another mix, even though it's looking so evenly distributed in the pan. It wouldn't hurt just to give it a little mixy-mixy. And I want the potatoes to lay flat, not all whole, so I'm sure it's going to cook properly. And make sure it's laying flat, but not where the skin is, but the potato itself, because you want it to cook properly. And then I'm placing this in a preheated oven at 400 degrees. Actually, I think no, yes, I'm gonna put it in the oven. I was thinking of putting it in a broiler and then, you know. But then I'm like, nah, because this is not pre-cooked potatoes, this is uncooked potatoes. So I would not put it in the broiler. I'll put it in the oven at 400 degrees and let that cook. I'm gonna give it 20 minutes and check back on it in 20 minutes. All right, so it is perfectly well distributed with some of this curry blend infused oil and also some of the seeds. We just also sprinkle along in there to just wake up the natural oils and flavors from those seeds, which would also get into our potato with all those other seasoning. All right. Before I put the potato in the oven, I just wanted to come and show you another quick option you could use to just to place your liquid in there. So if you have a skewer, you can. I don't want to bore too much holes because I already bored too much holes already in this potato, but I would for demonstration purposes, right? So you have a skewer, you want to bore a hole. Let me say I'm drawing a hole right here, not too thick. You don't want it to come through the other side because you don't want the liquid to run out, right? And then you're going to use this end here, turn it around, and just pass it straight through just to free up the space. Right? Again, you're not going straight through. Please don't. And then you will take your injector and put it in up to where the hole is, which is the last hole in this is here. And just put it in up to that hole. Don't go further. And you just squeeze. Squeeze. Squeeze slowly. You can see it puffing up there. I can feel it running back out, so I'm just gonna start taking it out. Right? So you can see all the liquid start to run out, so we don't want anything running out too much. Just give it a next little chuck here and a next. So you see how that previous hole right here? Let me just chuck a little bit back there. This has alcohol. You don't want to use that. You could just use something simple. I have another hole right here. Just chuck it again. I'm just showing you all where I had holes, right? So okay, let's. And the rest of this, I'm going to make a sauce to dip my potatoes when they're finished. So I'm going to place this into a small bread pan. You could fold it in a foil just to keep it in, but I don't. I want it to roast nicely. So I'm going to leave it open in the smallest bread pan that I have. And I'm going to add some of that very same oil on the skin here. And just rub it in. So I'm using 1 tablespoon and just rubbing it in, give it a nice good rub down and put that to bake along with your pieces. This would take a little longer because it's a whole potato. So remember the other one we put for 20 minutes? This will go longer than 20 minutes. So let's put them into the oven now. So for the first 20 minutes, let's make the dipping sauce. I have some tomato ketchup, some mustard, the sauce that I made to for the injecting of the potato, and I have some chicken broth that I have there, and bay leaf and clove. I'm going to bring that to a boil on a medium high, and once it has thickened up, I am adding no thickening agent to this. I'm just letting it boil down, and once it is good to my satisfaction, I'm going to leave it there. So the first 20 minutes, I took out the pieces and I'm giving it a stir, and I'm going to put it back in the oven. And this is the last 20 minutes. So altogether, I left these potatoes to cook for 40 minutes at 400 degrees. And let me give you a better view of what it looks like at 40 minutes. This is what it looks like at 40 minutes. Again, the sauce that I made to go with this would be the rest of the liquid from the sauce that I use to inject the potato. I use mustard, I use tomato ketchup, and some chicken broth that I had in the refrigerator. Put them on the fire to boil. Once it has thickened up, I'm going to use that. You can add salt and anything else, but I didn't because my green seasoning for the sauce that I used to inject the potato already had a lot of salt and enough flavoring in it. I didn't need to add anything, so it is sticking up. I am going to seal. So the baked potato is also done. The baked potato cooked for about almost an hour. The pieces cooked for 40 minutes, right? And I baked them at 400 degrees. So let me just see what this looks like. All right. Obviously it's cooked. Let's see the seasoning. That's what I am most interested in. So you can see where the seasoning has been placed in the potato, because especially the last one where I was doing the demonstration view, you saw that's where the seasoning. So the potato itself is full of flavor. So I'm God, I don't know why I'm getting calls. Oh, I forgot today's my birthday. Anyway, I'm going to remove this and put some cheese. Well, I guess this is one video that's not going to be monetized, huh? Because I'm getting calls. But so I'm going to remove the potato and season it up, and I'm going to eat this. I think I need to mute my phone. I keep forgetting that my phone is over there and I am recording over here. How you do up? Alright, ladies and gentlemen, so thanks for watching my birthday breakfast and how I use an injection method to flavor my potato. Alright, so let's give this birthday lunch a taste. It might be simple to you, but you know, if you go in a restaurant and ask for these types of potatoes, big bucks you have to pay. Well, at least in the Caribbean, that is. And this homemade barbecue sauce that I use with the seasoning from the baked potato that we injected. Right. So use that, the rest of that seasoning to make this with some broth that I also had there. And so let's give this a taste. Yes, sir. Happy birthday to me. Awesome recipe. Hope you give it a try. Thanks for watching and thanks for singing happy birthday with me. Bye. See you all next time. Sometimes the most simplest recipe turns out to be so delicious and enjoyable. I am not a very fussy person. I like simplicity. And this meal right here was everything that I needed. Nothing else. Nothing more, nothing less. I didn't need anything fancy. I am just thankful that I have health. I am alive. I have a roof over my head. And I was able to prepare a very healthy, nutritious, and filling meal for my body for this day that I have been blessed with another year of life. And I just pray for more and more blessings, health-wise, mentally, emotionally, physically, in every area of my life. I pray that Almighty God continue to guide and cover me. And I enjoy my very simple breakfast and lunch because it took me through the whole day after mashing it up. It was really good. And don't forget the baked potato. I'm going to use that baked potato to create also another recipe. So look out for what I did with that baked potato. All right. And thanks for joining me. Thanks for singing happy birthday with me. And again, ladies and gentlemen, thanks for always supporting me and my videos. Whether it be one of you, two of you, all three, no matter how many of you watch my videos, I am thankful. I am extremely grateful. Thank you again for all of you that sang happy birthday along with and for me. And let's pray that God continue to bless all of us in this YouTube community to continue to grow with each other and always be very supportive in each other's videos and all the content that we bring forth for you all to enjoy. And don't forget to check out my previous recipe. And if you're watching this and today is your birthday, happy birthday. And please don't leave without subscribing, liking, and sharing.